Hello everyone and welcome back to Genie Crafts. In today's video, we are going to see how we can create a layered mandala out of paper. And this layered mandala you can either put on wall as a decoration or you can also put it inside a shadow box, frame it and give it as a gift to someone else. So let's get started. Obviously, the first thing that you're going to need is a design for the mandala. So you can draw your own mandala or you can download some easy designs freely available on the internet. The design you see on screen is something that I have downloaded from pixabay.com, and I have also put the link in the description box. You can check it out later. For each layer, you will require a separate printout on that particular colored craft paper. These five colored sheets that you see on a screen are all almost 230 to 270 GSM thick paper, and for a layered mandala it's better that you use a thicker paper so that the paper do not bend once you start creating the layers. Also, with each layer the circles will keep on shrinking, so the bottommost layer will be the biggest one. When you cut it out, the next layer will be slightly smaller circle, the other one even smaller, and so on. I'll explain it in a little bit more detail in a while. For doing the actual paper cutting, I'm going to use this beautiful knife from Olfa. And now let's get started on our bottommost layer, which will be the first layer that we are going to cut out. For the bottommost layer of the mandala, we are only going to remove few mandala elements or the design elements near the border. Rest we are not going to touch because those will be covered by the layers which will be coming on top of the bottommost layers. These are the ones which I have pointed on the screen. Most of the mandalas are very symmetrical in design, so there is a way to speed up your paper cutting. What you can do is that rather than cutting out each element completely in one go, you can put cuts in the one direction along the entire design. Once you are done with one direction, then you can shift your paper and start putting the cuts in the other direction. You will see me using this trick throughout this paper cutting to speed up my paper cutting. It will actually save your time quite a lot. And here we are after cutting all the elements for the first layer, and now we will cut along the border to get our final first layer and see how it looks. Also, if you will notice that we have not cut the mandala till the center. The reason for that is that there will be more layers coming on top of this bottommost layer. So even if you cut till the center, it is going to be hidden by those top layers, so there is no point in cutting till the center. Only cut that portion of the design which is going to be visible after putting layers on top of it. Hence we have only cut along the border, because the next layer will be slightly smaller in size and the border will be visible, so we have made cuts along the border only. Now we move on to the next layer, which is obviously going to be slightly smaller than the previous layer, otherwise that layered effect will not come out. So for this layer, the border will be defined by the point till which we have cut in the previous layer. So all the elements which we have removed in the previous layer will now form as a border for this particular layer, which you will see later on when I cut the border. And this is how the layer 2 so far looks after removing elements from the mandala design. And now it's time to cut along the border, and you will see what I was talking about, taking reference from the previous layer. As you can see once again that we have not cut till the center, because there are more layers to come on top of it, and also the size of this layer is smaller than the previous layer. Once you put them on top of each other, you can clearly see the difference. Follow the same process till you reach the last layer, that is the topmost layer, and then once you have cut all the layers, align them on top of each other to see if they are aligning perfectly or if you need to make any modifications. And once you are done with this alignment and checking, then we can start by creating the gap between the layers, which will be our next step. I'm going to be putting this mandala as a wall decoration. So I need to create sufficient gap between the layers so that it gives a 3D effect to the mandala. So for this, I'm going to use this extra foam sheet that I have with me, and I'll cut thin strips of this foam sheet, which will act as a gap separator between the two layers. So I'm starting with the second layer from the bottom. I will cut four small pieces and one for the center, because center needs to be properly supported throughout the layers, otherwise it will sag in the middle. Put the foam pieces at equal distance from the center and also from each other, so that there is a symmetrical support throughout the mandala layer. Similarly, prepare rest of the layers also, and ensure that you are pasting these foam sheets on the printed side, because they will go under and will not be visible. Once you are done prepping the layers, now it's time to assemble the layers. Pick up the bottommost layer and keep the printed side face down, because now we are assembling the layers, so the final visible side should be on the top. Pick up the next layer, apply the glue on the foams that you have just now pasted on the layers, and align the layers properly and assemble it on top of each other sequentially. Once you have assembled all the layers, then it's time to put it against a background. Also, if you want, you can create a gap against the background layer, or if you don't want, you can simply paste the entire structure directly on top of the background layer. And here is our mandala after all the assembly and background and everything. And this is how it looks. You can clearly see the 3D effect because of the gap we have created in the layers, and it looks really beautiful on my wall. I have also tried to put it inside a shadow box, and it looked really nice inside a shadow box also. So it's up to you how you want to put it or use it. I hope you guys enjoyed this simple little mandala video. If you guys like the video, then please do not forget to hit the like and share it with your friends. Also, please subscribe to my channel for regular videos on paper arts and other forms of arts. I will see you guys very soon in my next video. Till then, stay safe, take care, and bye bye.